Hi, welcome to this video. Currently I'm reading this book about the Battle of Stalingrad in World War II. It's written by Anthony Beaver, I think. Before? Not sure how to pronounce his name correctly, but it's a great book, and it tells the history of the World War II Battle of Stalingrad, where the 6th German Army is closed in and beaten by the Russian Red Army. It was the first big defeat for the Germans, and more than I think it was about 200,000 German soldiers got captured. High casualties and both sides, and it was of a little tactical value, but it was mostly a battle fought for the ego of Stalin and Hitler. I recommend this book. It's really good. I'm reading the Dutch version. I think it's been brought out in a lot of languages. It's I think it's one of the must reads of all World War II books. But good, this video is not about this book. This book made me feel much more, feeling more appreciation for the soldiers of the Red Army and the soldiers of the German Army. Not their command, because there were some really bad decisions in that battle, but the way that the soldiers fought and hold on in the winter time, no food or barely no food, and no fuel, no ammunition. It's so hard. It was so hard of a battle. I really respect the normal soldiers that fought that battle, and I think this was a very nice occasion, a little bridge to the minifigure I got this week. I really, and not this week, it was like a couple weeks ago, sorry for that. I've got that figure from Custom Brick Ita. It's like Italian. It's an Italian new web shop. It just came online a couple of days ago. I bought this one off of his Instagram page. It's a Russian soldier, and I'm really surprised about the quality of this figure. It's really good, and I want to show you some this figure, just to let you know that the new kid on the block, the new website that's selling custom World War II figures, is a webshop that you should visit once, because it really puts out some really cool figures. Well, this one is a Russian soldier, like a guy that fought in Stalingrad. Of course, this is not a winter uniform, but it's a really good printed fig. It comes like this, with a printed head, printed torso, printed legs, and this gun. I'm really positive about this figure, so you will not hear a lot of negative comment on this one. But I have to say that the gun is not completely what I expected. I don't know which brand this is, because it is not a Brick Arms. Because the Brick Arms, the gun, or the I don't know the English word for where the bullets are in, the magazine comes off, and this one is stuck. It's molded as one, and this is not overmolded. This is painted, and I'm a Brick Arms fan, and this gun is just not of that level. And it's a good gun. It's not a bad thing. But I prefer brick arms. And yeah, that's it. Okay, enough about the gun. It's just an accessory. It's all about the figure. And this one looks good. Check out that printing. It's awesome. It even looks like, I don't think you can see it, but the little star in his collar is a little bit texture printed. So awesome. It's a 360 all around printed. Second face on the other side of the head. Yeah, the arms printed very good. Like I said, the head is printed and it looks awesome. One thing I really like about this one is that there's no flesh color on the torso. Because if you follow me quite a while, you know by now, or you may have noticed, that all my figs and all my World War II things of figures are yellow toned skin. Of course, this looks realistic. It's good, no complaint about that. But I prefer yellow skin because I'm a Lego guy from back to the 80s, and I believe Lego figures should be yellow. That's just a basic. That doesn't make this one bad, absolutely not, because there is no flesh, so I can swap it when I want to. I can turn, I can remove the hands, put yellow ones in it, and another different head on it, and I will do that after this review video. But I just want to show you how good this one is printed. It's a simple design. It's not highly sophisticated, but I don't know if the camera can put it up, but the dots on this line are so good. And the small lines here, it's the details are so, so great. I really like this figure. I'm gonna be ordering more from Custom Brick Italia. They got some really, really fast shipping. Of course, I'm in the Netherlands, they are in Italy, and I get it within 3 days or something. It's really, really fast. Yeah, if I would order from Brickmania, it would take like weeks for with normal shipping, not express or something like this. This was normal shipping, and it was within 3 days, working days. Three working days. I had it in house, so it's really fast shipping. I asked the owner of this shop if there could be if he mind me doing this review. He was certain enough about his figure that he said yes, please do so. And he also offered me to offer you guys a discount of a coupon code for a discount on his website. I will mention it in my description because I just lost it from my mind. I think I know what it was, but I'm not sure, so I'm not gonna say it because it may be wrong. I'm gonna write in the description. You can get a discount on buying figures. Currently, this one is out of stock, but he got some really, really good German camouflage figures at this moment that are really good priced and really nice printed. I really like them. I think I'm gonna buy myself one of those. Yeah, I am very enthusiastic. Hard word for me to say. I'm very happy with this figure, and I'm really want to buy more of Custom Brick Ita. I highly recommend it. Good figures, good, very good service, fast shipping, good company, and a new kid on the block, I think, should at least get a chance that you visit his website. I will put a link in his description. Check it out. It's awesome. I love this fig. So, now, thank you for watching. I'm gonna read some more about what guys like this did in Stalingrad. Gonna enjoy my coffee, and I hope to see you in the next video. Bye bye.